So you have an idea of what job you want, or where you want to go to school, or what kind of novel you want to write. No matter what it is, it has to do with what you want to be doing with your life. So good job. You've successfully filled that existential hole that plagues existence.
Take a seat.
So now that you have this idea of what you want, how do you achieve it? Well, as Napoleon Hill once wrote, a goal is a dream with a deadline. But while goals can get you to where you think you want to be, they can often get in the way of your true dreams, because goals typically restrict your vision with worldly mechanisms. But remember, this is all subjective. There are two types of people that this topic deals with: people who flourish by utilizing goals, and people who do better using dreams. And yes, there is a difference. A dream is something as simple as, I want to be a writer. A goal would be taking that dream and saying, I want to write 3 pages a day, so then in 1 year I have a 1,000-page novel. You see what I mean? One is bare bones, only stating your pure intent, what you ideally want, while goals are more realistic, attaching mechanisms to it such as time and quantity. But the point here is that goals can still be useful if you find that they work for you. But the bigger problem is that dreams are not held to the same regard that goals are. All my life, I was always told that if I want to accomplish anything, you need to set a goal to complete. And yes, that does work for some people. Last year, I was attempting at writing a novel, and I told myself I would write 3 pages per day. And most of the time, I hit that goal. But for some reason, the writing wasn't as fun. I started hating it. So then I stopped. But looking back, I know that I don't hate writing. I'm just not driven by goals. I'm driven by dreams. Now, when I say dreams, I need to be a bit more specific here, because I caught myself falling into a very specific trap. A dream needs to be boiled down. A dream is simple. See, earlier this year when developing a concept for a TV series, I thought to myself that my dream was to create a pilot to then pitch to studios such as Netflix. And it sounds about right. It doesn't have any fine details that would make it into a goal, and it isn't bogged down by being too realistic. But then I realized that a dream is not what you literally want from your life, but it's your intent on how you want to feel in your life. So I took it from creating a pilot to show to Netflix down to I want to create a story that people will enjoy, and boiled it all the way down to I want to tell effective stories. That is my dream. And the good thing about boiling it down, rather than attaching specifics to it, is that one, it easily adapts to your life, and two, it keeps you open to every opportunity.
I see an opportunity coming.
Let's dive into those a bit deeper, shall we? Easily adapts to your life. Something I never liked about goals is how specific they are. One day I create a goal saying I want to write 3 pages every day, then a few months later my goal completely shifts. Now I want to pitch a show to Netflix. The best thing about boiling it down to the core is that it makes sure that the dream is you. That way, whether I'm writing a novel, working on a series, making YouTube videos, etc., it all furthers my one dream: to tell effective stories. So keep it simple. Make it your own. And don't forget that it keeps you open to every opportunity. Take my Netflix goal, for example. If I specifically set my goal to create an animated series to be put on Netflix, what opportunities could I miss? Well, for starters, if an opportunity comes along to make that animated show into a live-action film, my goal doesn't really make any room for that. I would be so laser-focused on my specific goal that I would miss that opportunity. That's not to say that you shouldn't say no to that opportunity. You can say no to opportunities, but say no because you want to, not because your made-up goal is telling you that. I would start worrying about, okay, how do I pitch to a studio? What if they don't like me or what I say? Which is no good. The only time I want to worry about pitching is when I have a pitch meeting booked in my calendar. By keeping the dream basic, it helps me focus on what I really want. I could care less if I make anything for Netflix, but I do know that I want to make something, regardless of where or how it ends up. So if you're somebody who's realized that goals don't work for you, keep it simple. Don't focus on the specifics. Don't bog down your dream by adding due dates and time frames or any kind of specificity to it. Just focus on your intention. How do you want to feel? What do you want from your life that would make you feel passionate, fulfilled, and happy? Because in the end, that's all life is ever about. I'll see you all next time on Kunin's Cove.